Once upon a time, in a city that turned into a giant bouquet every spring, a place with a majestic river running through it, and fairy tale mansions, and manicured parks, and castles, a little girl was born to a prominent family. Her name was Sally. She had a privileged childhood, a lake place, private high school. She was her father's princess. She blossomed into a vibrant young woman and brilliant artist who went off to Europe, where she had a 3-year bohemian escapade. She landed the job of art director of the Marshall Plan, rooming in Paris with a glamorous ex-spy who kept a pearl-handled revolver and a pearl-handled stiletto. Sally formed a menage a trois with a famous artist named Tom Keogh and his famous novelist wife, Theodora Roosevelt, granddaughter of President Teddy. When Sally got sick and had to return home, she turned even that to her advantage. She sailed first class on the Ile-de-France, posing as an editor of Mademoiselle, dining with social luminaries. Back home, her life fell apart. She was no longer a princess. She tried to fix things by marrying the ardent suitor who had pursued her for years. After 20 years, their marriage ended. Sally was lost and had to find herself, not easy for a woman in those days. She looked everywhere: psychotherapy, religion, both Western and Eastern, even drugs. As a single mother of teenage boys, she cried a lot. Sally didn't read much because she thought she was dumb. A psychotherapist gave her an IQ test that showed otherwise. Sally became a scholar, then a therapist herself. Over decades, she developed into a beloved grande dame, helping hundreds of people. Sally had discovered how the pain that had threatened to devour her could be alchemized. Finally, at age 80, a grandmother with 3 successful grown sons, Sally was tired and ready to die. That's when she discovered the secret that keeps the spirit eternally young.